Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. Recently, I was having a conversation with someone and we were talking about Power BI. And they said, Patrick, I got a question for you since you think you know so much about Power BI. I have a table that has multiple dates and I want to do a difference between those dates, but I want to allow my report consumers to select which difference they want to show. How do you do that? Well, you know what I said? Stay tuned. I'm going to show you. Find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, dates everywhere. I moved that chair so I don't stumble this time. Anyway, I was having this conversation with this person and she's like, Patrick, I got a fact table. It's got like order date, ship date, due date. I want to calculate the difference based on some date that the report consumer selects and that date. So how many days has it been since the order was shipped? How many days since it's been actually ordered? And I was like, so easy. Let me show you. So you guys know how I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. I was going to use their built-in calendar table. And they said, Patrick, we can't use that because this is used to filter the orders they display. We don't want that to change based on this as of date. So what I did was I created a single column table. And you can build this how you want. You can put this in the source. You can write DAX to do this. You can use Power Query. So I created a single column table with just a list of dates from the earliest date to the maximum date. And I created a slicer out of that particular table, and I did a before, and you could have done an after, whatever. But if you go watch the datetime picker video I did, it explains, you know, all the nuances and why I did this and if I use before and if I use after. Okay, so go check that video out. Remember, this table is not connected to anything in my model. It's completely disconnected. So I did that, and then I created three different measures. I created a measure for order, and you can see I said date diff, and I grabbed the max of as of date because I said before. So the way it works is it's going to say, okay, here's a date. Give me all the dates before. So I have a list of dates. So I can't use selected value. So I say, give me the maximum value, which would be the upper end of that selection. So I chose the max value and that would be this value. And then I say, give me the minimum of the order date. I chose minimum. You can use selected value. You can use maximum because we're going to be displaying this data at the grain. So in my case, it's a sales order number. It could be anything. It's going to be on that row. So it doesn't matter if you use minimum, maximum, or selected value. It doesn't matter. I just repeated this pattern, replacing order date with shipped and then with due. And I dropped it into my matrix and you can see here's the due date, here's the order date, and here's the ship date. And if you take a look, my as of date is 3/2 and the day since that, right, 3/5, it's been 3 days. It's been 3 days as of that date that the order was placed, 10 days since it's shipped. If I change this up and go to 3, this will adjust and this is 2, this is 9, and on and so forth. And of course, you know, I got my Marvel t-shirt on and I was like, ha, there you go. She's like, nope, that's not gonna work. And I was like, well, why not? She goes, they need to select which ones they want to display. Maybe they want to say, show the day since it was shipped, the day since it was ordered, or the days until it's due. Or maybe they just want one of them. Or maybe they want all three. They need to have that flexibility. I'm like, well, just drag and drop. She goes, no. We're talking about report consumers. Patrick, it's just going to be a slicer. They're not going to be in the model. I was like, oh, got another idea. Let me show you. So I created another disconnected table called days. So let's go over to the data view and let me show you what days look like. It just has three values in it: ordered, shipped, and due. If you have more dates, you would have more values in this table. I just did enter data and I typed it in. And so I have these three values. And then I did not create any relationships. This completely disconnected table. And then I created a single measure called days since. So check out this measure. I grabbed the selected value from my days since. So this will be ordered, this would be due, or this would be shipped. And again, I grabbed my start date would be the max of my before. And then I did a switch statement to determine which one of the values I'm gonna do date diff on. And so in my case, I can see since what? So since ordered, give me the minimum of order or date. Since shipped, give me the minimum of ship date. Since due, give me the minimum of due date. Then I did my date diff and I returned the result. Let me show you what the result was. Here's attempt number 2. And now you can see over here, so right now shipped is selected. And 3/5 is my as of date. And as you can see, there was 12 days since it was shipped. I choose order, it's 0 days because they're exactly the same. If I choose due, it's about 12 days. I was like, whew. If you're feeling like a pimp, go ahead and brush your shoulders off, right? A little Jay-Z for all you guys who like hip hop like me. She was like, no. That's not gonna work, Patrick. And I was like, what do you mean? She was like, they need the ability to multi-select. They need to select either due and ordered and shipped, or maybe just due, or maybe due and shipped. They need to have that flexibility. I was like, oh, forgot about that requirement. Got another idea for you. What I did was I bust out, guess what? Tableau editor. And you can do this in 2 or 3, doesn't matter. And I created a calculation group called Days Since. I just right click, said create calculation group. I created an item for each one. So I use ordered as my selected measure. Okay, so the selected measure would be my Days Since order. And so I'm gonna use that in the matrix. And then for the other two items, I just took the exact same DAX that I use and pasted it in there. If you take a look at the calculation item due, you can see right here, all I did was use the due date. And then the same thing for ship, exact same pattern. Once I created it, I clicked save, went back over to Power BI Desktop. So attempt number 3, I built out my matrix. I added the name as my columns. I added the day since ordered in the value section because that will be my selected measure. You can see right here the due date. There's been 12 days since the due date. There's been 0 days since the order date and 7 days since the ship date. Let's go back 1 day, 13/1/8. If I uncheck shipped, you'll see ship disappeared. If I uncheck due, you'll see due disappeared. If I choose shipped, ship comes back. Everyone was excited when I showed them the solution. I was happy that I was able to solve the problem. All right, what do you guys think? Have you run across something like this before? Think about all the possibilities of calculation groups. I am right now. All right, if you have any questions, comments, you know what to do. Let's continue the conversation where? In the comments below. If your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.